Hello everyone. So today I want to show you how to set the parental controls on USB Loader GX. They nearly work by default. And the way to engage them is to go into settings, second page, parental control. And right now the console is unlocked. I've set the password at 1123 just by clicking password and typing in 1123. And then when I go back, this lock icon up here is where I would go to lock it. I'll hit yes. Now you see right now the game's number is 166. When I unlock the console by typing in the password, now 205 are displayed. Now the reason there's a smaller number is because some of the games were filtered out, right? And was filtered out based on the maturity rating of the game, but it's not always perfect. In fact, the default setting for each of these games, I'd say it's about 40% of the way there, maybe 60% at best. So the control level is similar to the ESRB rating if you're familiar with United States ratings. For example, if I set it to control level 0, then only games which have been set to control level 0 will be displayed, which is typically like every one level games in the ESRB rating system. And so on and so forth, right? But you'll see, if I go ahead and set this to everyone and lock the console, yes, and I go back, some of the games slip through the cracks. So let's go over to Resident Evil, for example. So obviously Resident Evil 4 isn't suitable for children. And you know, you see that they're rated mature, it says so on the cover. So why did they make it through? It slipped through the cracks just because their default maturity level setting is incorrect. Now, if I want to change that setting, I need to unlock the console. Hit OK. Now you see all games are displayed, and I've got to scroll back over to Resident Evil again. Right, and now you see these other Resident Evil titles that weren't displayed before. Now, those were correctly filtered out, although I'm not exactly sure which rating they had. If I click on the game and go to settings, under game load, parental control, so I'll set this to mature 16 plus and save it. Successfully saved. Okay, go to back. We also saw the Resident Evil 4 version was not correctly assigned. So for this title, I've got to scroll down a ways. God, this loop is ridiculous. Parental control, not everyone, but rather mature. Go ahead and save. Okay, go back. Good grief. Now let's just be sure which filter I'm applying. If I go to parental control, the control level is at 0. Now my interpretation, that means only things which are set at 0 should be displayed. So I'll lock the console. I've got to scroll back over to Resident Evil. Now you see Resident Evil 4 for the Wii is gone, right? And so are the other Resident Evil titles. Now while the console is locked, I'm unable to change the maturity level setting, so I can go back here. I'll unlock the console once again. 1, 1, 2, 3. Scroll back over to Resident Evil, and now you see the Resident Evil games are displayed again. Now, if you're watching carefully, you might have noticed that this Resident Evil game, when I first looked at it, was actually set to maturity level 0 under game load when we first looked at it. Now, I think there might be a setting hidden somewhere that, like, you know, the default way of filtering out certain games is based on the genre, and Resident Evil would have fallen under survival horror, for example. So it did get filtered out even though it was set to maturity level 0. And to me, what this means is that if I want to be very thorough and very sure that no games slip through the cracks in any way, then I'm going to go through them one by one and change the maturity level setting so that it matches the rating system. Or whatever you'd like, you know, perhaps you'd let your kids play Resident Evil 1, but unless you know that they beat it, they're not allowed to play Resident Evil 2. So you can set the filter so that you know, the game is locked behind the adults only filter until they beat the game in front of it. So I might not want my kids to play this out of order. So I'll say, all right, little kid, you know, go ahead and beat Resident Evil 1 and come and let me know what the ending is. And once you've done that, I'll go through and change the maturity level setting so that you have access to Resident Evil 2. And until then, you know, you can't play these out of order. So another very important thing for us to know is how to reset the password in case we forget it. What ends up happening though is that we don't actually reset the password, we just unlock the console manually, so to speak. So let's go ahead and lock it now. Now we're just assuming I'm forgetting the password, right? Okay. So what we need to do is turn off the Wii, take the SD card over to the computer, and edit one of the files there. So I'm at the computer and I'm at the root of the SD card. Let's go into apps, come on down to USB loader GX, and this file gxglobal.config is what we want to edit. So I'll right click and open with Notepad++, but standard Notepad would also work. This God mode variable is set to 0, change that to 1 and save it. Go ahead and close and eject the SD card and put it back in the Wii. And so we've got it. The console's been unlocked again. And just for your own sanity, you can go back into the parental controls tab and see what your password was that you forgot. So that's that. That's all I wanted to show you. Hopefully that helps you. Just as a bonus, I'll point out that if you press 2 on the Wii remote, it'll pull up this nice display. You can look at the game and then you can use the nunchuck to turn the cover around. If you click on this, then you can, you know, sort of hold it in your hands, so to speak. And if you press the plus button on the Wiimote, then you can zoom like really far in. And I don't know who created this database of really nice images, but they did a wonderful job. Like, I think this is really cool. So, and then press B to come back out of it and B again to come back out. So yeah, when you're shopping for which game to play next, you can kind of read through the back cover as you like. So that's all I've got for you. Thank you for watching.